pedal to make it dish your ace. This is the other manipulation that you can identify in that board. This is the abnormality that you can identify in that board.
Hypercellularity.
What is causing the hypercellularity? The connective tissue is already infiltrated by mononuclear or polymorphonuclear inflammatory cells?
Mono.
So the cell pointed, it has a scant cytoplasm, it should be a lymphocyte, and then the larger cell should be monocytes. When they are still in the blood, the tissues there we call
macrophages.
So that, what should be your diagnosis in that area?
Chronic
inflammation. This area here is also chronically inflamed. However, another abnormality should be the presence of the pink, iodine material. This is the diagnosis for site number 05. Neutrophils, are you able to see any neutrophil in that area where fibrin is deposited? No. So then there is a problem with the diagnosis in this slide. It should be chronic. Chronic fibrinous pericarditis. Now, unfortunately, there is no tissue left in this slide that will tell us that it is a pericardium. So, you do not have to write pericarditis. So, just answer chronic fibrinous inflammation. Chronic fibrinous inflammation. So, fibrin. Now, what is the cause for the deposition of fibrin in the connective tissue? Fibrin is normally located in what tissue? The body? The blood. Okay? It's one of the clotting factors. Now, why is there the possibility that it will become deposited in the tissues outside of the blood vessels, such as this case? Very good. Edema, very good. There is edema that will develop because of the leaky characteristic of the newly formed blood vessels. So this area can show us edema and the Genesis and Chronicles of our King Jesuit. We have made deposits. Huwag na yung magandang sa pericarditis na isang malibit na cardiac muscles. Now, what is the abnormality that you can identify? What is the abnormality in the pointed area? What?
Fibrosis.
Acute or chronic?
Chronic.
So this is what happens to the heart muscles. If you can remember your histology, the heart is myocardium of the heart is composed of diffuse sheets of cardiac muscle fibers. You will not be able to see any area of fibrosis in the myocardium of the heart. So the cardiac muscle fibers are closely spaced with each other. Now, when they die, they will become replaced with fibrosis. Why? Will it be possible for regeneration to develop in the heart? Why? Need to remember the three types of cells according to regenerative capacity. Avid, quiescent, permanent or non-dividing cells. Then up the heart muscle fibers belong to okay, that is why when they die, they will become replaced by the heart muscle fibers die, they will become replaced with fibrous tissue. What happens to the functional capability of that heart? Diminished. Okay? So this is the most probable cause for that, for the development of that abnormality. This is the most common cause of death of the heart muscles. You have already studied this because you have just finished the chapter on the disorders of the heart, ischemia, which is most probably caused by. What is the correct term for this ischemia in the heart? Myocardial infarction, which is caused by atherosclerotic plaque by itself will not cause infarction. Thrombosis over the atherosclerotic plaque, wherein it will produce complete obstruction of a coronary artery, which is already having atherosclerosis, and then on top of it, a plaque which will completely obstruct the perfusion going to that region of the heart. So this is an old infarct. Slide number 11 is diagnosed as what? Anyway, the fibrosis and amyloidosis will look very similar. Okay? So pink panel color. This is very confusing because we are able to see fibers in the area where amyloid proteins are supposed to be deposited. Remember the description of amyloidosis in the book is that it is hyaline. Okay, hyaline. But can you remember about the appearance of the hyaline cartilage matrix?
Glassy
or clean looking. It should not look like that is dirty looking already. There are fibers that can be seen. So most likely this is not amyloidosis but an old infarct, fibrosis. Of medium-sized arteries. And that's that is one artery, and then that is another artery. In order to diagnose the abnormality in these two arteries, let us first review the layers of the blood vessel wall. The pointed layer is called tunica intima, which is lined by the endothelium, simple. And then that area of the intima should be called
subthelium.
How about that fiber?
Internal
elastic lamina, and then that layer, media, and then that layer, adventitia. What happens to the lumen of that artery? Becomes narrow. Okay? Let us trace the outline of the lumen. Supposed to be, there should be an endothelium lining that area. Okay? So the endothelium becomes markedly thickened with this protrusion or with that abnormality. So that before discussing how that abnormality developed, let us first study this other blood vessel or artery. So that is supposed to be the media and then the intima of that artery. What happens to the lumen of the artery? Okay, completely obstructed. Now, what are responsible for the formation of that plaque obstructing the artery? Identify the cells pointed. RBCs. Okay, in terminating, among the clusters of the red blood cells are those pink colored fibers. They should be the fibrin deposits. Now they're called the succession of light colored bands, and then the dark colored bands formed by the red cells, and then another light colored band, and then another darker colored band, and then lighter colored band. Those are lines of suns, okay, which will be seen in how they call that the structure obstructing the lumen of that artery. That entire structure should be called a thrombus. Okay, now can you identify abnormality which facilitated the development of that thrombus in that shown portion? Look at the wall of that artery. Tunica media, tunica adventitia, then that entire thickness should be tunica intima. So trace now the thickness of the tunica intima. What is the abnormality that you can identify in the area pointed? That is the microscopic appearance of an atherosclerotic plaque. Okay? So those clefts that you are seeing are actually composed of cholesterol. Mga clefts na yan, they're composed of cholesterol. So cholesterol or lipids do not take any of the stains used in the slides that we are studying. That is why they will appear as clear areas. How about that pink hyaline materials? What compose the area outside of the lipid deposits? Let us go back to the pathophysiology of atherosclerosis. So primary to the development of atherosclerosis is the injury to what cells first? Endothelium. They will become activated. When the endothelial cells become activated, they will release growth factors. Growth factors that will stimulate particularly what cell in the blood vessel wall? Smooth muscles from the tunica media. They will migrate towards the sub-intima. When they reach the sub-intima, what will they do? They will proliferate, not most of the time. Because if they proliferate, we should be able to see smooth muscle fibers in that area. But there is no smooth muscles are hardly identified.
What is the most prominent thing that they will do? They will
produce collagen fibers and extracellular matrix components. So that is why, aside from cholesterol deposits, collagen fibers are added, which impart the hard consistency to the plaque. That is why eventually it will become called atherosclerosis. Sclerosis refers to hardening. Now we are able to see cells, which are cells with foamy cytoplasm. How do you call those cells?
Foamy.
Not foamy macrophages. Okay, so. So that's a new deformed thrombus. Again, you'll be able to see alternating red and light bands of sun. Then how about that abnormality? What happens to a thrombus? Okay, it may become detached and form an embolus. However, though, clots which are not detached, they will eventually form another clots. What will eventually replace the clotting factors, the platelets, and the red blood cells? What happens in organization of the thrombus? The thrombus will become replaced by fibrosis. Okay, that is an area of fibrosis. So let us examine the organized portion of the thrombus. This your diagnosis in that pointed region. Identify the cells pointed.
RBCs.
Are they still normally present when organization has already developed? No. Become completely replaced with fibrosis already. But what should be the most probable reason for their presence inside the organized thrombus? Very good. What? Recanalization. So what is your diagnosis for that? Slide number 21.
New one.
So that must be old thrombus. Identify the organ shown. Diagnosis for slide number 89, please. Increase. Now, the cystic formation in the tunica media. There is tearing in the tunica media because of the weakening of the tissues composing the tunica media. If there is an atherosclerotic plaque in the subintima, why will there be weakening in the tissues of the media? Tingnan niyo ang thickness ng tunica intima in that region. Wala abnormality na makita sa tunica media. And then, look at the thickness of the sub-intima in that region. There is marked increase in the thickness of the sub-intima and it is accompanied by abnormalities in the media. What do you think then is the probable cause for the development of the degeneration in the media in that form? Okay. So there will be impairment of the diffusion of oxygen and nutrients from the lumen to that portion of the wall. Supposedly, it should be compensated by those vessels which should be called.
Why diastolic?
Systolic or diastolic?
Diastolic.
Diastolic. because? When the wall becomes hypertrophied, what happens to the size of the ventricular chambers? Decrease. So that there will be decreased volume of blood that will be entering the chamber during diastole. So that the type of failure that will develop will be systolic failure. Diastolic, I'm sorry. Vasculitis usually develops from type 3 hypersensitivity reaction. What is the other name for type 3 hypersensitivity reaction?
Immune complex.
Immune complexes are deposited to the wall of the blood vessels. Now, if immune complexes are deposited to the wall of the blood vessels, why will necrosis develop eventually? Inflammation that will develop because of?
Complement system,
complement protein activation in the wall of the blood vessels. And then if the complement system becomes activated in the walls of the blood vessels, why will necrosis develop?
Neutrophils
will become attracted by what component of the complement system?
C3.
Not C3, C5A. C5A will become attracted to the wall. They will migrate to the wall of the blood vessel. They will become activated. And then the problem when they become activated is that they will release the contents of their lysosomes. So that is why in that blood vessel, we are not able to see any nucleated cell anymore, even the fibers na lang. So ideally, we should be able to see neutrophils infiltrating the wall of the blood vessels, including that area of necrosis. Why would we be able to say that that area is necrotic already?
No nucleus.
The absence of nucleus. So this slide is not a representative for necrotizing vasculitis. All the blood vessels here are almost intact and do not show any neutrophilic infiltration. Most likely, it will not be last
problem.
So identify the organ adduct muscle fibers in that area? What happens to the color of the part of muscle fibers in that area? Hyperius in the belief. Which one will indicate early myocardial infarction? That portion above or the portion the lower?
Lower.
Hypereosinophilia is one of the first abnormalities that will develop in acute myocardial infarction. Diagnosis Windows 38, next slide. Okay, acute myocardial infarction. That's why we are able to see hypereosinophilia. And then, during the first 24 to 48 hours from the development of myocardial infarction, what will be the predominant leukocytic infiltrate?
Neutrophils.
And neutrophils. Okay, and this is why we are seeing neutrophilic infiltrations among the heart muscle fibers. Normally, there are no neutrophils inside the myocardium. Next week, what will be our schedule?